Aki uses metaphors of scenes and objects to convey information rather than through language, and also creates a poetic aura. Dark appears in almost all his works. It is not only a physical space for the characters, but also a symbol of the character's mental state. For example, the ending of Kalamani Union, Ariel, and the Shadows in Paradise are all in the same way. The protagonist takes a boat to the other side of the sea, regarding the outcome of the protagonist. Aki decides to give us an open and poetic ending. The dog can be seen as a double metaphor for escape and hope. Modern industry in Aki's films alludes to the indifference of the state apparatus and the exploitation of the lower class. The opening of Crime and Punishment is a description of a slaughterhouse with bloody animal carcasses lying all over the place. In Ariel, the heroine's working environment is exactly the same. The opening of The Match Factory Girl also depicts the details of 80s assembly line work. Furthermore, the opening of I Hired a Contract Killer even has a George Orwellian portrait. Everyone in the waterworks has become part of this alienated industrial machine. Also, Aki's films are partially influenced by Luis Bunuel, which contains surrealism style. In The Man Without a Past, M is declared deaf by the doctor, and then the doctor and the nurse move away. M, with the gauze twined over his body, suddenly stands up and rises from the dead. In the series of Leningrad Cowboys films, the plot is based on the adventure of band members traveling around America and finally arrive in Mexico, which is full of offbeat absurdness with their pointy-toed shoes and outrageous pompadour hairdos. While in Leningrad Cowboys Meet Moses, the plot of CIA running down Moses for stealing the nose of Statue of Liberty is truly hilarious. In Take Care of Your Scarf, Tatiana, Reino fixed the car by simply moving a big part out of the hood, and similar scenario happens in Juha, when simple and honest Juha pulling out a huge funny spanner to repair Shemeikka's broken car. From the preference on realism in his early period works to a diversion on grimness, alienation, sagacity and modesty, Aki concentrates more on life itself. In The Man Without a Past, M falls into a Franz Kafka's way of dilemma. After M lost his memory, he is obstructed by government, banks, and other social institutions. In modern society, human beings are nothing but symbols, bank account numbers, yet the values of being a human itself are often being ignored. Moreover, only in a container slum does M can pull himself together and start his life afresh. A shabby container turns to be a neat and clean makeshift home after he washed it, and he also plants potatoes, which gives me a feeling of idyllic life. He loves music, working as a manager for a band. He then falls in love with a Salvation Army female worker. At the end of the film, we finally know his previous life condition, which creates a slight dramatic conflict to the audience. Although Aki draws on Hitchcock's approach of setting up the suspicion, Aki's films are not typically genre films. His films do not concentrate on how to tell an intricate and splendid story, but on the living status and experience about the characters. The plot is subordinate to the linear logic of characters' living conditions. Characters try to change themselves due to loneliness, and then they got demise. They start to feel frustration, and then they fight back. All of his films tend to show a complete slice of life in Zolaism attitude. There is no narration interspersed with flashbacks, only a chronological plot without any embellishment. Aki's films have already shaped a stoic camera shooting style before Dogma 95. Chronological narration, source music, natural light, minimized action and simple setting and mise-en-scène, as well as a fixed crew. All the elements make his films retain high uniformity. Timo Salminen works as the cinematographer in almost all of Aki's films, which makes Aki's films have a consistent fixed photographic style. Other collaborators on art and design remain unchanged, including cast aforementioned. Aki's films are not as coarse as they seem, apparently. On the contrary, there are ingenious details lying within. In The Match Factory Girl, a pot of epithelium blooms and then fades soon, which implies the tragedy of the girl's one-night stand. In Drifting Clouds, the posters on the wall in the cinema are L'Argent by Robert Bresson and L'Etlong by Jean Vigo. Now this complaint and these posters clearly shows Aki's nostalgia towards previous cinema and an aversion against the excessive violence and stereotyped cliché of modern cinema. He considered those commercialized films manufactured by modern Hollywood are killing artistic values of cinema. In past, we just used a murder for telling a story, and nowadays, the director has to kill 300,000 merely to draw one's attention. The threshold for violence will become increasingly high as time goes by. And actually it's worse now. We can see it through what he once said about the man without a past. In an interview, I would like to explain the violence in this film because it makes me feel uncomfortable. The problem is, the story has to start with violence. So I wanted to at least make it honest. Because if people want to see violence looking good, there is something wrong with their heads. So I make it look as it really is. Fast and ugly. This is my rule and my explanation. I always remember the scene in Lies in the Dusk when Koistinen sits Ingmar alone. There is a scarlet rose inserted in an emerald bottle, placing on a clean white tablecloth surrounded by chestnut wall. The saturated color delivers a sense of alienation of Edward Hopper's paintings. Aki once said in an interview, "My audience is getting older and older and so am I. It's funny, I was a film buff 20 years ago. Everybody went to the cinema all the time. You had to see every film ever shown anywhere. Now everybody has a family and they are in debt. Prisoner of banks. Nobody goes to the cinema anymore. Except the children who want to see Hollywood shit. Nowadays, the average age of my audience is 60 years old, while I'm 31 years old. Old ladies who are either divorced or whose husbands killed themselves, which is okay for me. At least I have an audience." Overall, let me quote a piece of Charles Baudelaire's poems to conclude. "Am I not that dissonant chord in the divine symphony, thanks to the insatiable irony that mauls and savages me? That spitfire irony is in my voice, and all my blood is her black poison. I am the sinister glass in which she looks on herself. I am the wound and the knife. I am the blow and the cheek, the limbs and the rack, the victim and the executioner."
Elämä on jotenkin mielenkiintoista. Minun mielestäni olisi kaunista, jos ihmiset kohtelisivat toisiaan paljon paremmin. Luultavasti kalat tappelevat tuolla vedessä ja syö toisiaan. Mutta se liittyy eloonjäämistaisteluun, että se on sitten toinen juttu. Mutta ihminen on kirjallisuutta ja kaloilla ei ole. Ihmisten pitäisi sitten tietää paremmin, että luodaan järjestelmä, jossa ihmiset ei syö toisiaan. En ole nähnyt vielä merkkiäkään sellaista. Mutta luonto on kaunis. ja tämä hölpötys siitä, että ihmiskunnan pitäisi olla parempi, niin mä oon alkanut päätyä siihen johtopäätökseen, että se on parempi, että ihmiskunta häipyy. Se häiritsee luomakunnan omaa kehitystä. Ja niinhän se tulee häipyä. Mutta katsotaan sentään sen verran, että jo syntyneet elävät elämän. Sitten häivytään. Niin kuin minä nyt.
Tänään kuljen hymyillen, vaan tiedät tulevaa pelin.